Hello everyone, this is Yom from Civil Center. Welcome to our channel. As we know, Civil Center is continuously working with the vision to guide civil engineering student and professional. And for that, we have started a series on Tekla Structures, and there is also another series on how you can become a consultant. So if you want to know how you can become a consultant, then you can just find a link in the description. You can check out the free webinar and book a strategy call with us. And if you want to learn the Tekla structure, then this video is just for you. So we have already covered the RCC structure and how you can do the detailing of RCC structure in our previous videos. And now this series has added steel structure in itself. So if you want to learn about the RCC structure, check out the previous videos on the channel of Civil Center. And if you want to learn the steel structure, then just follow the series. So if you have liked this video, then hit the like button, share it with your friends and colleagues, and subscribe to our channel. And let's start the detailing of steel structures in Tekla structure. So guys, you can see this is our interface of Tekla structures, and in our previous video we have done the modeling of the base plate. So here we have two different methods of the base plates, and if you want, then you can simply reverse it. That's already up to you. And there is a bonus point for you: if you want to just copy the properties of any object, then you have to just double click on it, and then it will open up a dialog box for you. You have to just copy the properties from there, and then you can simply paste it to the another model of the same thing. Like, I'm just copying the properties of the base plate over here, and I'm trying to paste it on this one. Or if you remember the previous video, then you can simply change the arrangement of the bolts and everything that you need just from the here. Okay, so you have different options over here, and you can easily and simply change the arrangement from here. Okay, so like this, you can use these two different ways to set the arrangement of the bolts over here. Now in today's video, I am basically going to focus on how you can change the display of your Tekla structures interface. So for that, you can go to the view, and from there you can go to view properties and click on display from here. Okay, so this is one method of doing that. And then another method of doing the same thing is that you have to just double click on interface and anywhere other than the grid lines or components, and you can find the display over here. Now from here you can decide how you can want to regulate the visibility. Okay, so if you want everything to be visible, then you have to just click on all, and then in model and in components. And if you want to just make a selected things visible, then you can just continue like this. Like if you want to go for the reference lines only and not the exact view, then you can see the reference lines only. Okay, so you will have to also mark the parts over here, and then you can see the reference lines of this steel frame. Like this is a column, this is the rafter, and this is the footing. Okay, so like this, you can simply mark the reference lines over here. Okay, next thing is that if you want to see the exact view, then you can also see the exact view like this. Next thing is that suppose you don't want to just make the grids visible, then you have to simply unselect all those points. Now if you want to make the points visible, then you have to simply check over here and click on the points. Then comes the volts. Okay, so if you want to see the bolts in the model, then you can check it, and you have to just go for exact from here. Then the holes, welds, and everything can be like make visible from here. Now next thing is the construction planes. If you want to make the construction plane visible, then you can just click over here and then click on modify, and your construction planes will be visible. Okay, so you can see these are the construction planes that are visible over here. If you don't want to see it, then you can simply remove them, and this will be invisible from your site. Okay, so like this, you can just use all these things. Next thing is the reinforcing bar. So let's press Control plus 1 to switch the view. Okay, So you have the reinforcing bars over here. Now, if you want to deselect it, or you want don't want to see it, then you can simply just uncheck the box edge and click on modify. Okay, and now you can see the bars are gone. Next thing is, let's bring the bars first. Okay, so let's see. Now you have the bars. Now I am switching the views from here, but you can also switch the views from here. Like this is a wireframe structure. This is the parts grayscale. Click on modify. Then you can also go for rendered view. Click on modify. Then the shaded wireframe structure. So all these things that you can simply do from here. Okay. Next thing is the surface treatment and the surfaces. Then the pore break, and I'm going to check all the boxes so everything can be visual from here. Next important thing is cuts and added material. So if you have some kinds of cuts and added material, then that will be visual. Then the fittings can be made visual from here. Next thing is the component symbol. If you want to make the symbols visual, then you can simply make it visual from here. Okay, then comes the grids. So you can see the grids are invisible right now, but you can click on modify and you will get back your grids. So you can do the similar thing for the construction line, but I don't think I have used the construction line in this model. So it will not be visible to you, but if you will just make the construction line visible, then it will be visible to you automatically. Now, there are a few more things that you can do over here, in the bold section, we have the fast and the exact. Okay, so you can just choose between them and basically try to stay with exact one. Okay, then the construction planes, then you have the reinforcing bars and the welds. Okay, so we know that this is a base plate and we have to go for welds over here. So we can modify that and you can see now the welds are visible. Okay. So like this, you can make the welds visible. And if you don't want to see the welds, then you can just click on exact, but no weld mark. Okay, and it will be gone. Okay, so like this, you can just choose between all these things. Okay, suppose you want to go with this and then you have to go for exact. Okay, now I would like to go for rendered view of the whole model. Okay, next thing is the cast in place parts and the cast in place parts. Okay, so if you work for a long time in the Tekla structures, then it may appear a black screen before you, but that's nothing to worry because the Tekla structures work like that. Okay, so there is nothing to worry about that. Next thing is that if you want to put some kind of label in your model, okay, so for that I will just zoom out and you can see I will simply click on part labels. Okay, now click on modify and let's choose few things like material. So let's add the material over here and click on modify. So you can see we have our materials with us, like FE450, then ISO 2062, then M30. So these materials are visible now. If you don't want to see the assembly portion or the parts label, then you can simply remove that also. Okay, now if you want to just see the name of it, then you can also add the name over here. Then the profile, class, everything can be added. And if you will just click on modify, this will show you the details of all the things. Like for this rafter bar, the metal is M440, then the name is beam, then the profile is ISMB 450 and class is 3. Okay, so like this, you can just add or remove anything from here. Okay, so let's click on modify now. You can see we have our properties with us. Okay, next thing is the connection text. So if you will just check on this one and click on modify, then you will see that we have this connection text with us. That means this is our base plate, which is the connection text. Okay. So So guys, in today's session, we have learned how we can use the display and we can mix different things, visual and invisible, in our model. So if you have found this video interesting, then hit the like button, share it with your friends and colleagues, and subscribe to this channel. And if you want to learn more about this Tekla structure, then you can simply stay tuned to this series of Tekla structures, and we will meet in the next session. Okay, so till then, take care. And if you want to make your career as a building consultant, then check out the description. Thank you.